In today's video, we are going to be talking about texture and using different materials and modeling paste to do different textures with your acrylic paintings. Here we have the artist. This is my dad, Stephen, and my name is Jess. I am Jess. Let's go through this.
A blockbuster about to open up.
Okay.
Oh, look at that. An alien landscape buried in snow. Isn't that yummy?
Yeah, so this is what we are going to be creating today. And this can give you a bit of an idea about the types of textures you can achieve using really simple household things, you know? So lots of different types of netting, things like fruit bags.
Yeah, onion bags. Fishnet stockings.
There you go. And some rope.
Anything really.
Yeah.
Use your imagination on this. I mean, we're just doing a few things. This is some of the products that we use to put all together. That one in the middle is called silica flour, and that's what we used to do in the old days, but it's very, very dangerous to try it yourself unless you're fully masked.
Yeah.
Because you can get silicosis. These are the tools we use, all sorts of tools. In fact, you can even use old credit cards or anything that you don't need just to make, even a hard cardboard's okay for spreading if you haven't got fancy damn stuff.
Mm.
Here we are with the first one.
Yeah, this is the first of three. So this netting is kind of like...
It's very stretchy.
Yeah. And it's interesting watching you apply it because something like this where it's really stretchy... You can actually move it a bit on the surface.
Get a nice, uneven, swirly, twisty sort of thing.
Yeah.
I mean, it depends. You can be very, very careful and make it very even. But in this case, I like the fact that it has that geometric, absolute accuracy in that these little squares, when you pull them out, diamonds, they all line up with each other. But so it's much more fun to... make them twist. You can do an awful lot with that. That's me gesturing hypnotically.
And just, you can just use, you're just using masking tape.
Oh yeah, just tape it down.
Yeah.
You really need to tape it down, believe me.
Yeah.
It wants to go walkies. Look at that. I like that. That's fun.
Now this is the Atelier modeling paste that you'll be using for this particular video. And you can use this too. You can access this probably by online or from an art shop. If you're not in Australia, because this is an Australian brand.
It is an Australian product.
Yeah.
It is available overseas though.
You'll be able to get it overseas or maybe something that's similar.
Anybody that makes acrylic paint will make this stuff. I would hope so anyway.
Yeah.
It used to be, it is sort of like silica flour held together with acrylic resin. Notice how I'm holding it down as well and just very, very flatly, not applying. We're letting, at this stage, we're letting the onion bag create the textures. We're not kind of being too... trying to keep it fairly flat. See how I'm really flattening that down, filling those little squares.
Yeah, there's all these little nooks and crannies and things with the bag. So you're just laying it down flat, so it's fairly even for that one. Yeah.
Just doing a little bit. This is just demo stuff. This is a much finer bag. This also, I think oranges or something came in this originally.
Oh, yeah.
It's more smaller mesh, and it's not quite as flexible as the other one. So we're being a little bit more formal with this one. Basically, you can see where I've cleverly cut the corner so it doesn't get in the way. I fold them over. This is quite stiff to work with. It's not as flexible as the onion bag. It does do a little bit of a stretch if you want to, but it's not an awful lot available.
Yeah. Maybe when you're in the supermarket next time or when you're buying your groceries and things, you can even just sort of like feel the different textures of the bags and how much give they have, if they are flexible or not. And that can... sort of help indicate like what kind of textures they might give if you can actually move them around or not.
Yeah, an old pair of fishnet stockings if you've finished with them. Just avoid the holy bits. The cigarette burns in your fishnet stockings. Everybody has them. Don't feel ashamed about that.
And now
slapping it on.
So you're just, this one, are you still, you're still trying to get it fairly flat and...
Pretty flat. We'll see what happens. I get quite inventive with this. Ah, now we're not going flat anymore. We're having fun with it.
Yeah.
This raises little peaks and then spreading it out. Now that creates little pop marks. Like you create the peak, you lift it up and then you whip the top off it and it leaves... so you get, we're getting two layers of texture, one ghosting over the other, which I find rather fun.
Mm. Now, do you remember how long you might have, you didn't leave this for that long taking it off?
This stuff is acrylic paint, so it kind of only lasts, it's 20 minutes and it's too hard. And because it's a glue, if you don't whip it off too soon,
then your mesh is stuck on there.
It's stuck in it. And there we go.
Yeah.
Now, it's trial and error. So you might find that by playing with it some more, maybe use up a few dud sheets for a start to get the, you might have an idea in mind. When you finish with it, chuck it in water and then you can recycle it again.
That's good.
Because it does, as I say, this stuff is silica flour and acrylic. It just dries rock hard. Here we're using this stuff. I don't know where I got this.
Yeah, this is a different kind of one that's not as common, but maybe this is some kind of like...
I think it's like gutter guard or something like that. It's stuff you get at a hardware shop.
Hardware stores, yeah.
Yeah, I think that's what that is or something like that.
Yeah, and this one does not have as much give or flexibility about it, really. Mm. And, yeah, it's a bit different, but it's good to experiment.
Once you get the idea of what this stuff does, basically you can use any kind of meshy type thing and play with it. I advise you just to experiment. We will show you what happens to these in another video when we take it to the next stage.
Yeah, we're going to have a part two and yep. That's going to be very exciting with lots of glazing and painting, colouring and making these just transform, really.
Yes, this is the first of the series. Mm-hmm. This is like the first Star Wars.
Well, they're
stay
all
tuned for the 50th version.
Yeah. Now that Disney's got a hold of it, of course. and this one here also, because the mesh is a lot harder and tougher, it's also harder to sort of lay down the paste.
Yes, and I was using a broader spatula thingy with that, yeah. A trowel with that, because the whole scale of it is a little bit longer and I wanted to really feel that. This is the one we're doing before with all the craziness. See how we've kept the craziness there as well as the underlying mesh. It's sort of like, I called it a ghost texture. So you've got a texture over the top of another texture.
Mm.
Again, chuck it in the bucket.
Yeah.
Because we can do, you can use this stuff.
Because essentially it's just basically like plastics and things. So you can just wash it, rinse it,
yep.
Dry it, use it again.
Yes,
yeah.
Ready to finish. Gesturing again, I have no idea what I was saying at this point of time, but it looks very important.
Now here is, using rope as well.
Yeah.
So you can include like string, rope, different...
Wire.
Yeah.
I actually did have a whole bunch of little copper wire things, but we ran out of time. But seriously, folks, you can choose anything you like that's going to mask off. What we're doing is we're just masking off the texture, so putting the texture, putting the paste on, lifting it off, and then that creates this extra line. So you can put lines in there. You can even do wiggly stuff. You can wire's good because it'll stay in one place. You can create a little pattern with a wire splattered over the top, lift it off, and we'll do the same thing.
Mm-hmm.
Obviously, if you're using something with high profile like rope, or where notice how much goo I'm putting on, quite a
very
lot,
very thick,
quite a lot more. Doing the plastic mesh, not a lot is required to get an effective texture. Oh, I'm playing with a fork here.
Yeah, so you can use different tools just around your home. Like this is just a
That's a wooden takeaway fork from my ecologically sensitive whole earth place I get my Friday lunch from. Yes.
You can, yeah, that's great.
Owl Whole Foods Canungra, folks. You must go there. Free plug for them. They make the bestest food ever.
And, yeah, you can do little crisscrossy textural things with something like a fork or a comb or, and you have that control over it as well. Yeah. And if you do go really thick with the paste, then you can go quite deep with the tools and have more bumpy textural things happening.
And my advice is not to... the effect in itself is really interesting. You don't have to overdo it. I think in some cases, if you do, then the way we put the glazes on and wipe back and do that, you've got a bit more control. If you try too many tricks at once, it's like putting too many ingredients in a stir fryer. That's how I cook.
Yeah.
Way too many spices, and that'll kill each other. And it's just a basic design principle. If you put too many elements into play, instead of supporting each other, they vie for attention, and that can kind of rob the painting of a nice, mature, balanced. It's just too rich, too overdone.
Mm.
I'm just fiddling now with using the fork again, but doing a softer texture, sort of a soft echo of what's going on. In some cases, down the bottom, there's a bit of random stuff, but then I'm also doing the crisscross thing just as a soft echo, because there's quite a strong mesh up and down that I put down.
And just looking at it, you're able to do a few of these at the same time because they're drying fairly quickly. You don't have to just sort of sit and wait for it.
Mm.
You can do quite a few in a short amount of time, which is really awesome too if you're wanting to make a lot of these and sell them or give them to friends and things like that. Mm. It's a fairly quick process.
These exercises were just working on using texture purely for its own sake, creating abstract little panels. You can use it to enhance realistic paintings, and we'll show you one of them one day.
And wiping off the jar is also really important before you put everything away.
It's like glue. If you want to open that jar again without using nuclear force,
gotta clean it up.
So here we've got these lovely soft creamy things. Now they're fairly low profile, that's not, but the other end is. But you can enhance by the way you glaze it and seal this.
Mm-hmm.
And you do have to seal it, folks, because this is quite gritty. It's crystalline in structure, and so it absorbs lots of paint. So I'll show you in the next vid how we actually do that.
Yep.
You got a lovely dragon skin, lizard skin, snake skin, fish scales, that sort of thing.
Yeah, very exciting.
It's fun to do a fish scale thing. Well, I'll show you. We do one of those later.
Yeah, we'll do a fish scale one too. Mm. Yeah. I hope that you got a lot out of this video. Let us know. Give it a like and subscribe to our channel as well. We would love your support. Yeah, look forward to the next one where these are going to be glazed, coloured, painted, some really exciting things. So looking forward to that.
And we'll reprise these a little so you can see what happens to them.
Yes. All right. We'll see you next time.
Indeed. Bye.
Bye.